Hello children, in today's reading session, we are going to read a beautiful story from your literature book, Granny's Tomato Soup. Granny's Tomato Soup, this is the story from your literature book. Okay, so come on, bring on your books. My little book of literature, lesson number 8, Granny's Tomato Soup. It's a beautiful story. Let's read it. I will read it for you and then you will have to read it by yourself. Okay? Long ago, an old lady lived in a village. Everyone in the village called her Granny. Usually, we call Granny to our grandmother. We call them by this name, Granny. Okay? She grew vegetables in her garden. Many children pronounce this word as vegetables, which is wrong. We say it like vegetables. Vegetables, okay? She grew vegetables in her garden. One day, Granny wanted to have some soup. Onion soup? No. Tomato soup. Yum. So what this story says that long ago there was a lady who was living in a village. She used to grow vegetables in her garden. One day she wanted to have some soup. Then she thought of having onion soup. Then she said, no. I want tomato soup. It's yum. So let's see what happens next. Tim, the tailor, walked up to Granny. Tim, there was a tailor named Tim. He walked up to Granny. May I have 4 tomatoes, please? Yes, for sure. Here they are. See, Granny was going to make tomato soup with the tomatoes. But then Tim, who was a tailor, he came there and he asked for the tomatoes. Then Granny said, okay, here they are. After that, Fred. The farmer was walking by. See, Fred, the farmer, was walking by. Hello, Granny. May I have some tomatoes, please? Yes, you may. Thank you. And now rest of the tomatoes, this farmer takes. Now let's move on. Jane, a young girl, was passing by. Hello, Granny. I love tomatoes. May I have one, please? Yes, Jane. Sure. So she gave one of the tomatoes to Jane. Now, Paul, the postman smiled at Granny. Good morning, Granny. May I have some tomatoes? You can have all of these. So she gives all of her tomatoes to Paul, who is a postman. Now let's see further. No tomatoes, no soup. Look here, no tomatoes left for her, not even hair in the basket. What will I have for lunch? Now. Granny, look what we have brought for you. Tomato soup. Oh, thank you so much. So, how was the story? Everybody took out the tomatoes from Granny, Hena, and she also gave them and she said nothing that I also have to make soup for my lunch. She said no. She didn't say no to anyone, Hena. So, but what happened at the last? All those people, they made soup for her and brought it for her and then she really liked it and she said thank you to all of them. So I like the story, really. I liked it very much. I hope you learned something from the story that we must help everybody, you know, forgetting about ourselves, and that good will definitely come back to you. The good that you have done to all those people, it will definitely come back to you. Okay, let's do this little back exercise over here. Who are they? Match the columns. Fred. Who was Fred? Fred was a farmer. Tim. Tim was a tailor, Jane was a young girl, and Paul was a postman. Okay, so draw two things you like to have for breakfast, color the picture and name them. Here you will draw any two things that you want to have for your breakfast and color them too. Okay, so you have to read this chapter on your own now. That's all for today. Bye-bye. Take care.